Okay, so to my friends in SS1, this is actually the last video that I'm doing for this particular past question. So after this video, the subsequent video of SS1 will be another question entirely. Okay, so let's just two more questions to go. This is question 42. It says, the number of electrons donated by an atom of magnesium during bonding is what? This is magnesium, Mg, emphasis, the way, you know, following IUPAC, there's a way we write the first letter with capital letter, not that you write something like this, and then even if you write it big like this, this is still small letter, no matter how you write, if you write it like this, no matter how big you write, it's still small letter. So you have to be bold, capital letter, then small letter. It's very important. For example, to write chlorine, you don't do like this and you do like this. No, it has to be like this. You have to, you know, follow IUPAC. Okay, so this is magnesium, and what we have 24 here 12. You know, magnesium is 12. So normally when we have element, we denote it by X, we have something here, Z, and we have A. This is called atomic number. The Z is atomic number, atomic number. The A is atomic mass, what we call mass number. So same thing we have here. So this is magnesium, 12 on the periodic table. So now when we look at it, we say number of electrons donated during bonding. You know, magnesium, we have 2, 8, 2. You know, it's 12. 2 plus 8, 10. 2, 12. Following K, L, M, shell of a tin. So 2. So you know, this one will serve as the octet. If you draw it, if you use dot and cross this thing, if you drop, we have 2. The next shell, we have 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and the last one we have 1, 2, and this one is free. So this is the valence shell and valence electron. So this is what we use in bodies. You know, it's easy for magnesium to donate, to lose 2 electrons and form the stable structure, 2, 8 structure, other than gaining 6 other. So it's going to lose. So the number of electrons donated, that's why they said donate. Magnesium metals already donate. They recently donate, you know. So, you know, you find metals in group 1, group 2, and group 3. They easily donate. Donated by an atom of magnesium during bonding is what? These 2, not 1, not 12. If you donate all of the 12, nothing left again. And not even 24. So, it is 2. I hope it is clear. So, that's actually a simple distance. So, let's see the last question we have here. Last question here has to do with question 48. It says, which of the following phenomena is not an evidence in support of the particulate nature of matter? You know, particulate nature, what particulate nature of matter? I'll be talking of Dalton's atomic theory, things like that. You know, normally, Dalton's atomic theory, by the time, they told us that it fails to account for electrolysis. It cannot talk about electrolysis at all. It can also not talk about isotopy at first. But you know, Dalton's atomic theory, later, it was what? It was modified. You know, Dalton's atomic theory actually depends on the 4 chemical laws that we know. Law of conservation of mass, law of constant composition, law of multiple proportion, you know, all those laws. So it's based on that. So law of conservation of matter, see, matter cannot be created nor destroyed. So, but we now know in the modification that matter can now be created when we have reaction of maybe radioactive reaction. Radioactive reaction. When you see modification of that in atomic theory, you see it. But actually, it's a topic in SS3, you know. So now, okay, so that's not the modifier that when we talk about one of his laws says that no two atoms look alike. But in the modification, we are told that we can have 2 atoms that will look alike, and that's what we call isotopy. Maybe we have chlorine, chlorine 35, we have another chlorine 37, you know. So we have it like that. So that's called isotopy, a set of atoms that have the same atomic number but different mass number. So now it can now so that to now answer the question, phenomena that which of the following phenomena is not an evidence? The one that is not an evidence. Diffusion will be an evidence because all matter will diffuse. Diffusion is movement of a particle from one point to the other. So gases can diffuse, liquid can, so diffusion is there. So electrolysis is not. So let me know that diffusion is supports particulation of matter. Osmosis also supports it, and it's not one of our answers here. Osmosis supports it because osmosis is a other case of diffusion. Osmosis will happen in liquid when we have a permeable membrane. So, for example, if you have a solid salt, maybe sodium chloride, salt, the common salt that we know, you put inside water, you dissolve it, and now put a permeable membrane, it will permeate and pass. So now, isotopy now is now a phenomenon that supports particular nature when Dalton's atomic theory was modified. So isotopy also now supports it. The only one that remained that could not support it is electrolysis. So a particular nature of matter could not account for electrolysis, a topic that you learn very well in SS2. So this is our answer here. Diffusion will account for it. Osmosis will account. Isotopy will account in when Dalton's law was modified. Isotopy will account for electrolysis.